Hey, what's up everybody? My name is D and welcome to Smart and Good Channels. So in the last few videos, I already showed you guys how to create the online store. And in this video, I want to share with you guys a cool way of bulk upload products from your spreadsheet to the online store. So basically, this is the online store that I am building right now. So in the last few videos, I showed you guys how to install this websites right here, how to set up WooCommerce, how to add dropshipping to the websites, how to sync products from the website to eBay. So I figure this will be a very useful videos to share with you guys how to bulk upload from your spreadsheet to WooCommerce, because there are a lot of people that sell physical products, and this is a fast way to upload products to your websites. And you can make like different changes on the spreadsheet, and then when you hit the import, it'll update your whole inventory on your website. So it's very cool. Now let's get started with the process. First, we will need the website. Now if you haven't watched my last few videos, go watch those videos and you know how to create this online store. But once you are here, you can go to the dashboard of your website, and if you scroll down, you will see the all imports. If you don't see these options right here, go to your plugin and find WP all imports and activate it, then it will populate right here. But once you are here, simply click on the new imports, or we can click on the manage imports. Okay, now let's go back to our spreadsheet. We need to set up the product status. We can enter the titles, the price, the sale price, categories, subcategories, descriptions, and even the image link. Now you can use the URL as your image, or you can go back to your products later and upload your image, but I would recommend this method right here. Let's say if you only have one image link, but if you have multiples image, you can simply just add more into your spreadsheet. Okay, so right here we have like all the features that we can later manipulate and create in our descriptions for our products. Okay, so let's say you already have this one. The next thing we need to do is that go to your file, go to share, publish to the web, and right here you can choose the sheet that we are working with. So this is a sheet one right here, and we can click on the CSV file. Okay, once you're done, click copy this link right here and hit publish, since I am already publishing right now. Okay, so I can access out. I just copied the link. Then we can go back to our website. We can check out this template right here, or we can even create a new template. Let's create a new import right there. Okay, so we can click on this download a file from the URL, and then enter the URL we just copy, and then hit download. Okay, so we can scroll down right here, go to your WooCommerce products. Okay, and then hit continue to the next step. Now this plugin right here, WP All Imports, is a premium plugin that we have integrated into smartandgood.com. So when you sign up for our websites with smartandgood.com, for the right plan, you will get this plugin for free. Okay, and this plugin even come with the WooCommerce add-on, which is a premium add-ons also, but we make it available for our subsite. Okay, so once you are here, it shows you like of the title, the price, the categories from your spreadsheet. Okay, we can click right here to continue. Okay, so once you are here, this is a very fun part of like adding the spreadsheet to your website, is that you can map these titles right here by just drag it over here. So for the descriptions, we can add the descriptions right here. For the short descriptions, we can add the short descriptions right here. And if you scroll down, you will see the WooCommerce add-on. we can click right here. Okay, for the regular price, we can enter the regular price right here. For the sale price, we can just drag it right here. If you want to manage your inventory, you can click right here, and you can create a stock column on your spreadsheet, and then you can manage it from your spreadsheet right here. For example, let's say you want to create a column. We can click right here, quantity. Okay, we can enter like 3, for example. Okay, go back here. You will need to save this, and then you would need to refresh this for this to populate over here. Okay, but I'm just gonna say no right here. Okay, for the attributes, you can even add attributes right here. You can customize it. Very simple, very easy. And right here, if it's a downloadable product, you can click right here, and it will show you the file path. You can just drag the link over here. So for example, this is the image link, but imagine this is a download link. We can just drag it over here. Okay, so this is a physical product, so it's not downloadable. So for the image, just click right here. We can enter the image link right here. Okay, if you have multiple images, you can just put the comma right there, and then just drag it over again. Then now you have a couple of images for your products. Okay, we can just delete this one. Okay, if you scroll down, you see the SEOs and advanced options. You can click right here. Okay, set the titles, set the captions and stuff like that. And we even have the Yoast WordPress SEO add-on. You can even drag the SEO title right here. You can drag the focus keywords. For example, if you have a focus keywords on your spreadsheet, you can just drag it over here, just like that. Okay, you can enter descriptions for your products. I can just use the short descriptions right here. Okay. Now we can even create custom field. So down here we have the products categories, we have the brand, the tag. So I just choose the category, and then I can enter the category right here. If this one has multiple categories, we can click right here. Okay, enters the first category, and then put the comma, and then enters the second category, just like that. Okay, if you scroll down, we can click right here to save settings as a template. Okay, so I can create a new template. Okay, or if you already have a template, you can click right here to load the template. Okay, so this one is templates one. Okay, click continue to the next step. Okay, so now we can add like a different tag to identify our unique product. Okay, we can scroll down here. Here are a few settings that we can do. For example, if you want to delete products that are no longer present in your file, you can do it this way. So when you click import, it will do the automatic work for you. Okay, so I'll just leave it. Okay, continue. So once you are here, all you have to do now is just hit the confirms and run import. Okay, so when you do that, you can click on the online store right here to go check out the new imports that we just did. It shows you like import completed, one record created. Okay, we can click right here. We can scroll down, and as you can see right here, so this one I did last night, and this one is the one we just imported. Okay, so this is just one. We just test our spreadsheet, and now it's linked with the websites. Okay, so here, as you can see, we have the short descriptions, we have the price, the regular price, the sale price. Okay, and down here we even have the descriptions down here. Okay, so let's say if you want to add multiple products, we can just simply copy off this, and we can just drag it down, and just like that you have like multiple products in your spreadsheet. Now let's enter a different name for them. Okay, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so let's add 5 more products to our website. Okay, we can delete these. Now, I already copied the link and pasted it here to make a shortcode. Just simply click right here and then it will open the imports. Okay, so right here is the new imports which is created. We can just simply hit the run import and we can confirm and run import. So it's processing 5 records right now, created 4. Okay, and just like that, we can go back to our shop, and as you can see, we have 5 different products. Okay, so it's cool. Let's go to AliExpress and we are going to borrow a few images from their store, and we are going to borrow this image right here. Copy image address, go back here and paste this right here. Okay, one. Okay, let's borrow this one too. Okay, paste this here, copy this one, paste this here, and then this one, paste this here. Okay, so we can create new categories. Okay, so scooter. So whenever you enter a new category right here that's not already exist in your website, they will create a new one for you. And if you have the same category, they put it into the same category for you. So down here we can create like a mountain bike, girl bike, for example. Okay, so you can easily manipulate your spreadsheet and then easily make the changes for your websites. For example, this one is 1000, okay, 500. And when you are done, you can go right here to open a new import, or you can just like go over here, okay, and scroll down and go to your manage import. It's the same link, you know, you can copy this link and make it a shortcut for your spreadsheet. Okay, it's the same thing. Close this one. Now this is the run import. We can click run import right now and we will update our products from the spreadsheet, and then hopefully it changes all the images and all the data we just enter in our spreadsheet. Okay, so the import is completed. Go back to our shop, refresh the page. Okay, as you can see, we have the updated images right here. This looks very cool. All right, so let's manipulate the templates. Okay, we can go back to the import, we can make the edits, make the changes to the imports. Let me show you what I know, so you would know too. Okay, so if you like this video, feel free to subscribe and like to support my channels. Okay, so down here, let's say you want to create like a features list for your descriptions, right, for your short descriptions. You can simply like go right here. Let's say, for example, you want to enter a text feature, and then scroll down, you want to add like a bulletins. Okay, we can add this products features right here. Enter, add this features right here, and this one. Okay, so we can click on the text right here and we can copy this one right here. Okay, we can even cut it. We can leave it as the long descriptions. What I usually do is I would do this for my short descriptions. Okay, we can even click the previews. Okay, make the changes for our templates right here. When you are done, hit update. Okay, so when you are done, you can hit the run import again, confirm and run import. Okay, import is completed. Go back to our store, refresh it one more time. Okay, so let's check this products out. And as you can see right here, our features with a list of bulletin features. Okay, and down here we even have the related products. Let's check this one out to make sure they are in the same uniform. And there you are. it's very cool. Now you can like go back here, make all of the changes here, and you can bulk upload product to your online store, and you get to keep your inventory on a spreadsheet, and you can manage this from the comforts of your phone. Sometime when you are not at your computer, you can go on your phone and you can make these changes to these data right here. It's a very nice way to manage the inventory for your website. Okay, so creating this online store series is coming to an end. If I have more features, I'll make videos to share with you guys. If you guys like this videos, please like and subscribe. I would very appreciate it. And if you need help with your store, or if you want me to build the store for you and do all the setting for you, feel free to contact me and I'll be more than happy to help you with it. I want to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.